All right. Good afternoon, everyone, judges, attendees. My name is Jason, and I'd like to thank you very much for coming in today, and a very special thanks to the organizers for putting this event together. Today, I'm going to share with you a curious story. It's a love story, in fact, from the animal kingdom. I'm going to tell you about the most hopeless romantics on Earth and their affection that is absolutely limitless. It's a story, I hope, that can teach us much, not only about these animals, but about ourselves and the way in which our mind works. This is the Julodimorpha bakewelli, also known as the giant jewel beetle. They are an Australian variety of a very common family of Buprestidae, beetles with mesmerizingly shiny backs, and as a matter of fact, have a rich history of being used in jewelry here in Thailand. Back in 1983, biologists Darryl, Gwynne and David Rentz researched these little creatures when they began to notice a peculiar behavior. Turned out, these little bad boys had a fetish. The males of this species fed head over heels for and tried to mate with big, empty bottles of beer. That's right. As soon as you tossed a brownie beside the road, these perverts would flock in massive hysteria and get busy with it faster than you could say, "Look, free beer." Suffice to say, our biologists were fairly impressed with their findings. And before long, Rentz and Gwyneth went on to publish their most infamously titled paper and winner of the 2011 Ig Nobel Prize, mind you. Beetles on the Bottle: Male Buprestids Mistake Stubbies for Females. That's a real scientific study, folks. I guess they don't call them giant for nothing. All right, joking aside, this is indeed a very puzzling behavior. Why was this? Why, in a world that designed species specifically to, above all, survive and reproduce, would these males elect to behave in a way that's so counterproductive? In fact, these males oftentimes enter hour-long trance binges of futile copulation attempts, ignoring their surroundings completely, including actual jewel beetle females, intense sunlight that would end up drying them out, and even predatory ants as they eat them alive. Nature was up to something, ladies and gentlemen, and science demanded an answer. Well, as it turns out, our biologists discovered that the solution to this conundrum lied in a term coined 10 years prior by Nobel laureate Nicolaas Tinbergen: supernormal stimulus. You see, unlike people, jewel beetles aren't conscious. They don't have the faculties to extract meaning out of life or be self-aware. What they rely on instead are cues and triggers, and those specific cues and triggers can be amplified. When a male jewel beetle is looking for a mate, he's not looking for a female per se, no. He's looking for a unique combination of color, size, curvature, a shiny jewelry appearance perhaps, and even temperature, all to which he's been primed. By matching this unique criteria to the male Julodimorpha bakewelli, a big empty bottle of beer lying beside the road looks like the biggest, most beautiful female he's ever seen. And he's not alone. Studies have found that songbird parents would prefer to feed fake baby birds with mouths wider and redder than their real chicks. They couldn't tell the difference. Seeing red, literally, male stickleback fish would ignore real rivals to attack wooden replicas with red underbellies. And perhaps you've even seen yourself moths fly kamikaze into a burning flame or a bright light because they think they're navigating using the light coming from a distant moon. And the list goes on. Supernormal stimuli is the artificial stimulus nature has never prepared for. For these natural animals to react to an unnatural world that mankind has created, it would take at the very least many more thousands of years of adaptation. So, you might ask, what about humans? I get it, right? Fish, bugs, birds, and we created it all, right? So they're falling for our little tricks. I mean, surely this wouldn't apply to us, right? You tell me, does any of the following sound familiar? Refined foods are overabundant in fats, sugars, and salts. Fantasy games and TV shows that mimic real-world conditions and improved conditions. How about adorable cartoon characters and mobile emojis that are cute as babies? Or online sexuality that entices us even though we're alone? Do you sometimes spend more time on social media than you do with your family or friends? Do you take medicinal pills that help you think, sleep, hype up, calm down, grow muscle, lose weight, kill pain, or get high? Yes. We too are affected by the unnatural, supernormal stimulus. Throughout the hundreds of millions of years during which our brain has evolved, none of these existed. We built it all in the past droplet of a second that was the past century. These are the stimuli we can't help but want, even though we know we shouldn't. Just like the poor male giant beetle trying to get busy with an empty brown stubby. But fear not. For there is one difference that separates us, you know, Homo sapiens, from the rest of the pack. You see, we know the difference. Sure, we may feel the pull towards prefabricated thrills, but we can also think and determine that despite our senses, junk food is bad for us and healthy food is good for us. That spending time with family is more important than playing Farmville online, and so on and so forth. So there's one lesson I'd like you to take from this talk here today, and from the male jewel beetle and his love of beer, it's the following. Pay attention. Attention is the best tool you have in your human arsenal. Attention is what makes you, you, and your decisions your own. Thank you. Thanks.